Summertime Madness is quite a looker as far as puzzle games go, and if I'm being honest, it's one of the best I've played so far this year. The game is out June 17th for PC and Mac, but will be coming to all consoles later in Q3 of this year. Hey guys, it's Cody with Indie Game Pulse. If you want to find the newest and best indie games and hear genuine reviews from an indie game fanatic like yourself, click subscribe and the notification bell to make sure you don't miss another video. Let's get into it. Thank you to the developer for sending a review code my way. Summertime Madness is a beautiful addition to the first-person puzzler genre, and when I say it's one of the best I've played this year, I mean it. I've played several others, Sizable, Down in Bermuda, to name a few. They're not first-person, but they are definitely puzzlers. But not only does Summertime Madness hook you with a good story right off the bat, it also consistently delivers idyllic landscapes and engaging puzzles. Not once did I feel completely stuck, or like I was wandering around in circles, and a big part of that comes down to the genius hint mechanic that the game utilizes. I'll come back to that in just a minute. As the story goes in Summertime Madness, you are a painter in a war-torn Prague in the year 1945, quietly taking solace in your profession as a painter while the world outside your home is being torn apart. One night, suddenly a mysterious man materializes with you in your studio and offers you a deal that you cannot refuse. Step inside your painting to find peace and solace, but you must find your way back out before midnight or you will forever be trapped inside your own creation. At this point, if you accept his offer, your first real choice comes into play. How long will you wager that it will take you to escape? The classic mode offers you 6 hours in real time to escape, and the advanced mode only grants you 3 hours to escape. Although, in the end, these choices only somewhat matter. I'll come back to that in a bit, but it's the one thing that dampened my experience, and it is a slight spoiler, so I will warn you before I mention it. As your character enters his painting for the first time, you'll quickly learn to move about with WASD and using the mouse to look around. And then you run with the shift button or toggle run with X, which I quickly did and never looked back. And then it's up to you to find your first puzzle and begin solving it. I won't spend any time breaking down the puzzles or anything like that, but there is a nice variety represented, from your classic exploration style puzzle where you look for different levers to pull or bells to ding and doors to open, to a more isolated puzzle where you simply exchange flames on candles until all of them are lit. The game never explicitly tells you how to achieve each puzzle, but it is easy enough to intuit after a few minutes. A prompt will come on the screen when you're within reach of an interactable object, which you simply click to activate. What I love most about the puzzles in Summertime Madness is how if an action you've done causes something to happen off screen or out of view, it will switch to a brief cutscene to show you what has happened, and a bit of area context as well so you can find it a bit more easily. This especially comes into play as you explore bigger regions later on, like Neo Prague, where you have plenty of walking and switch flipping to do. But the game always makes sure you know, one way or another, what you have just activated. I do quite like the mix of puzzle mechanics that the game throws your way, and in particular my favorite puzzle section was the Neo Prague area, with its mix of day and night cycles, and loads of exploration. At any point in the game, you can check your pocket watch with the tab button to see how much of your 3 or 6 hour time limit is left, and if you're feeling especially stuck, which I'll admit happened to me 2 or 3 times, you can click to ask for a visual hint. Again, this hint might not give you the full context and flat out answer, but what is so genius about the hints in Summertime Madness is that they cost you time. Your only and most precious resource. If you think you'll never find an answer, of course it's worth it to get a hint, but it's not something that you can simply use to breeze through the game without a thought, and I love that. Now, since we've delved a bit into the gameplay here, I won't spoil anything about the story or the ending, but I will mention why the time you chose at the very start may or may not matter in the end, and this is truly my only complaint with the game. So, minor spoiler alert, I'll put the save timestamp on the screen now, and this is your last chance to skip ahead. Okay, I played on classic difficulty, having 6 hours to remove myself from the painting, but right before I entered the last room, I had over 3 hours left to complete the game, or so I thought. Upon entering the last puzzle, my time wound down to 15 minutes left. giving me a strict time limit, which I actually didn't meet, and it frustrated me a good bit that I had done so well throughout the rest of the world, only to have my time taken away from me and causing me to fail. Fortunately, you can retry the level, but again, only with a 15-minute timer. This is my only gripe with the game, and I'm just not sure why it's there, other than to give an increased sense of urgency as you try to escape. It feels a bit cheap. Anyway, back to the good stuff. Once you complete the game in either Classic or Advanced mode, a new Explorer mode will open up, and there is no time limit to escape, so this can be especially helpful in finding every last one of the collectibles you'll inevitably be searching for, and we'll talk about that in just a second. The art in Summertime Madness, as you can probably tell, is quite lovely, with a watercolor look to most scenes, with others being a stark departure into other surreal elements, such as the endless stair scene in particular. One of the paintings earlier on really reminded me of my time playing Genesis Noir even, with its stark blacks and white streaks of light, but all the scenes really portray a surreal world, something born from an imaginative mind and more beautiful than the cold reality outside the painting. There are also a lot of collectibles throughout all the different paintings you'll explore, even more than I could even identify in my first playthrough. A few of them in particular are quite thematic, like signatures hidden on different objects, or instruments strewn about the landscapes that you can even play for a bit if you wish, and as you find and interact with these collectibles, they will be documented in your achievements menu. I don't think I actually completed a single list, but the more diligently you look, the more you will certainly find here. The soundtrack too is quite peaceful, and for the most part I didn't really even notice it. Occasionally, when I found an instrument to play and slowed down for a second, some nice classical themes did come to the front. The sound design overall though is very well done, with wind, rain, and other sound effects sounding perfect. Even when you walk through a tunnel while it's raining, the rain muffles a bit, and there are a lot of small pieces of detail that go a long way with the sounds in Summertime Madness. So the question is, should you play Summertime Madness? I highly recommend it. For a puzzler that you can sit down and play through in an afternoon, there seems to be so much more in the world that I didn't get to experience, namely all the collectibles that I didn't find, and the Explorer mode will be helpful for those wishing to complete every list. The puzzles are a great variety, and no one puzzle seemed to stick around for too long or become tiresome, especially with the inventive hint mechanic. If you enjoy games that are not only fun and engaging to play, but also look excellent, Summertime Madness is the debut passion project from DP Games that turned out beautifully, and I hope you'll get the chance to enjoy it too. Thank you very much to my 1,065 subscribers for your support. If you like what you see here at Indie Game Pulse, consider helping us grow by supporting us on Patreon. For more top indie game countdowns and reviews, check out the videos on your screen now, and I'll see you on the other side.